Hello and welcome. My name is Stephen D'Amelio. I am president of Pride London Festival, and this is Pride Live. I am so thrilled and honored to be presenting some of the biggest names, inspirational talents, and amazing talents across North America, and of course, from our own city here in London, Ontario. I want to thank every single one of you across North America who's tuning in right now. You might be tuning in on our own Pride London Facebook page, or on many other social media networks that this is being shared by. Once again, thank you to our sponsors, to Tourism London, and to Pepsi for making sure that this event is taking place during Pride. We're so thrilled. And of course, to Spectra for producing this event in Budweiser Gardens. Now, today we're going to be presenting, as I mentioned, a number of great talents. One of the amazing things about Pride is sharing some of the most inspirational and fantastic stories and music from across this country and across the United States. One of the things we wanted to do was give you a great sense of belonging, of community. So today, we're presenting a lot of different unique acts. One of the first acts that I'm really excited to be talking about is Rick Kish and Nevin Campbell. Now, Rick has been working as an independent music and theater performer in various capacities over the years. He's been proudly graduated with a BFA from the University of Windsor and School of Dramatic Art. Rick has actually also received a master's degree from the University of Western Ontario as well, and the Don Wright Facility of Music and Literature Performance. He's the recipient of the 2019 Four City London Music Awards and a nominee for the 2020 Four City London Music Awards. He is an accomplished musician in his own right, an award-winning jazz and solo musician and performer. Rick is extremely talented. I'm so thrilled that we have him here. And one last thing to mention, he is artistic director for Link Theatre, which of course performs around the province of Ontario here in Canada. Nevin Campbell is also another musician that works alongside Rick. And Nevin is a jazz pianist from London, Ontario as well. Nevin is a graduate from the prestigious jazz performance program here at Humber College, just in Ontario, and has studied some of Canada's top jazz pianist. He's studied with a lot of amazing people. You can actually see him perform regularly at restaurants around the city of London, as he plays with a lot of local musicians across Ontario, and finest musicians and ensembles, including Rick. Today, I am thrilled to be interviewing the one and only Rick Kish. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Rick Kish.
Hello. Good to see you.
It's so fantastic to have you here. How are you doing today?
I'm good. Thank you, Stephen. How about yourself?
I'm doing well. You know, it's a bit awkward doing this virtually. I know that a lot of us would certainly love to be in person and hugging one another. But, as we are in Ontario, we are certainly trying to ensure that we're all keeping our safe distance and being following the protocols. So again, I wanted to thank you for being a part of this. This is such an amazing thing that you've taken your time out of to do. One of the things I wanted to ask you right off the bat was, what got you started into music and into performing? How did that start for you?
For me, as a kid, it was a common occurrence for my mother and I to sit down and watch movie musicals together. so many as kids, The Sound of Music, The Wizard of Oz. This is just something that we did. And I started to realize as I was growing older that I really love listening to people sing, and then I used to experiment myself with how would I be or sound as a singer, and started to play, and then to discover, and then to study, and then perform. That's ultimately sort of the path I took. But for me, it was mom and I sitting down and watching movie musicals. It's huge part of my life with my mom.
that's so amazing. And you know, to anybody else that's listening out there, you know, if you're interested in getting into music, as Rick had said, fantastic way to kind of have that introduction and just get a basic understanding. And as you were saying, you know, it's practice. It starts at home and then kind of works your way up. And speaking of working your way up, as I mentioned earlier, you've worked your way up so far to the point where not only are you performing across fantastic cities and amazing areas, but you're also an award-winning artist, not just recognized here locally, but of course all over. specifically locally, as I mentioned, though, you were recognized as the winner of the 2019 London Music Award. I'm curious, when that happened, what was that trajectory like for you? Did that kind of make things go in a crazy situation, or how did that look as after that happened for you?
You know, it's funny because when the award happened, I was absolutely gobsmacked because I wasn't expecting it. And so I got to stand on the stage and thank, of course, we're back to Mom again, to say thanks, Mom, for inspiring me to do this. But it was incredible. 2019 was an incredible year. I did more gigs that year than I had done prior in terms of, you know, individual standalone gigs, restaurants, theaters, concert venues. It was an amazing year. I linked up with Nevin Campbell to create something called the Rick Kish Combo. And as a result, we were doing all kinds of stuff. I met amazing musicians through that process. Started working with more and more musicians, which was really exciting. And just, you know, playing and experimenting and upping the ante on the whole music thing. And I'm so thankful to the Forest City London Music Awards for that real push. It also forced me into a position. I mean, I was, you know, to be honest, maybe a little lazy before that. And then the award happened. I was like, I better get my beat together and get work in here. And so we did. And lots of great things have happened. It's been a pretty amazing time since. And then COVID hit, of course, and everything came to a screeching halt. So we started doing some online stuff, but we're really excited to get back at it. I'm really excited to get back on stage. Like I was saying with somebody the other day, I would be happy to sit in the corner at a restaurant somewhere with me and Nevin at the piano, and we'll just you know, we'll keep our social distance, but just let us do it in front of an audience, please.
I can definitely understand that. The audience, I'm starved for an audience as well. I'm a DJ as well, so it's certainly something I definitely understand. And you perform better when you're feeding off that engagement. So I definitely understand that. You know, it's interesting that you mentioned that, you know, once you won that award, that really kind of kickstarted the ability to reach out and connect with other artists and create this Rick Kish Combo, this amazing connection. And of course, expand on that music ability. So it's fantastic that that's exactly what kind of came out of that, more opportunities. And as you were saying, you know, as things open back up, we're going to hope that we continue to see more of those opportunities in physical spaces. I'm curious, when you were going through these, as you were mentioning, you were listening to, you know, musicals and you were getting inspired by that. As you've gotten to this point of an established career and an award-winning position, and you've met so many different artists, are there any artists on the way that maybe inspired you to change your craft a little, or maybe introduce something new?
Oh, there's this. Yeah, I'm obsessed with TikTok. I'm not. I don't do the TikTok thing myself, not yet. But I am obsessed with watching videos, and I've discovered this young woman. Her name is Laufey, Laufey, and the simplicity of her performance and the she's an American singer. The simplicity of her voice, the simplicity of the way she approaches classic melody, especially in jazz music, I find so exciting and so inspiring. And so what I'm hoping to do is get together with some of my guitar playing musician friends and do some pared down versions of some of the songs that we often do in really big ways based on how her approach to the music has inspired me, for sure. I love this woman's voice. So check her out, Laufey, E-Y.
Laufey, is that correct?
Laufey.
Perfect. So check that out. With somebody who is inspiring Rick Kish, and I'm sure there's lots of people out there who are watching this. If you're inspired by, you know, a YouTube artist, a TikTok artist, or even Rick, you know, that's definitely what you need to kind of keep pushing you forward. So that's fantastic to hear. I'm curious, so some of those new people, one of the last questions I'd like to ask is, for new people that are watching this, or people that are interested in getting into music and becoming a musician, or even musical theater, what advice would you have for them, not only navigating through, you know, the unique time we're in now, but as we're going out of that. Is there any advice that you would give for an aspiring artist, such as the young ones out there?
Be bold. Be bold, be creative. Don't apologize for anything. If you have an idea, if you are inspired by something, share it. Don't be afraid. Try to be as fearless as possible, because what you do is unique and what you do is special and heard. You'll find your audience. So that's what I would say. I really think that that is probably... I probably in the beginning what helped me most was being really bold and asking questions and saying, hi, I'm here. I want to do what you do. I want to go on stage in your space. I want to be part of what you do. And it's being bold is, I think, a really important process, part of the process. So, and especially now you have to find your way to get your voice out there until we can get back on stage. And my gosh, there's so much available online. There's so many different platforms. Oh my gosh. So explore them. And yeah, be bold, be brave.
That's amazing advice. And I mean, frankly, it's perfect advice for this time of the year as well, for Pride Month. You know, be yes. bold in everything you do. But obviously with music as well, you know, be confident in what you're doing as well. And you know, listen to individuals like Rick. They're accomplished and they certainly have, you know, some knowledge and know what they're speaking about. So thank you for that. That's certainly helpful. And I hope that anybody that's watching and listening will, you know, take that advice. And as Rick had mentioned, there are a lot of platforms out there, not just TikTok and YouTube, but lots of other platforms that are looking to showcase you. So that is fantastic. I know that we're going to be getting into some of your music in just a quick short moment, but before we did, I just wanted to clarify, people can see just underneath your name is your website, rickkish.ca. If people yep. are looking to find out more information about you, where else could they find out information?
I think Google search of my name takes you to Facebook, takes you to Instagram, takes you to YouTube, etc. So I think that's probably the place to start. Or everything also is funneled through rickkish.ca.
Perfect. So the website again, rickkish.ca. And everybody go ahead and check it out and see exactly why Rick is an award-winning artist. And thank you so much for the time today for the interview. I really appreciate it, Rick. And really, again, I'm really, really thankful for you and Nevin coming together and creating this combo. I'm so thrilled to see that, you know, as you said, that win of that award has kind of propelled this combo. So it's amazing to see. And I'm excited. So thank you once again. And again, folks,
thank you.
Please. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
No, I wanted to say thank you and cheers. Happy Pride, everybody.
Happy Pride. I need to get myself a drink. Well, everyone, folks, please, please enjoy the next performance. This is Rick Kish and Nevin Campbell, the Rick Kish combo. Thank you.
Hey, everybody. My name is Rick Kish. And this guy here to my left in the red is none other than Mr. Nevin Campbell, or as we like to call him, Mr. Tinkle Fingers. Appropriate. So we've decided we're going to kick it old school, and we're going to do a couple of tunes, and here's our way to celebrate Pride. And we are so excited and thankful to be part of this. So happy Pride 2021, and you'll know this song as soon as I start. Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, come on baby, kiss me. Oh, fill my heart with song, let me sing for evermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you. Thank you.
right, so we're going to take you on a little tropical journey here. I don't know about you, but I have been desperate to get on a plane and fly somewhere and just hang out on a beach and watch life go by while I sip my margarita. I think you know what I'm talking about. So here we go. Tall and tan and young and lovely, the boy from Ipanema goes walking in. When he passes, each one he passes goes. When he walks, he's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gentle. And when he passes, each one he passes goes. He watches him sadly. How can he tell him he loves him? Yes, he would give his heart gladly. But each day when he walks to the sea, he looks straight ahead, not at he. Tall and tan and young and lovely, the boy from Ipanema goes walking in. When he passes, he smiles, but he doesn't see. Happy Pride, everybody. Thanks.
Well, welcome back. Thank you once again to Rick Kish and Nevin Campbell, the Rick Kish combo. I hope everyone enjoyed that. Again, they are amazingly talented artists. Rick, of course, is an award-winning artist, as we just talked about. Please go and support the artists that you're hearing today, all the performers and artists across North America. Would love your support, whether it's through PayPal or just a like and a subscribe on their page, or even booking them if that's something that you have the opportunity to do. Rick Kish can be found at rickkish.ca, and more information on Rick Kish can be found on Google, as he mentioned as well. Again, I want to thank our sponsors, Pepsi and Tourism London, for being involved in helping put this show together. It's quite an amazing opportunity for all of us to come together during Pride Month. And of course, for Spectra and Budweiser Gardens. Now, I want to go into just mentioning a few quick things. First of all, Pride Month is really important, but it's important for a lot of people for a lot of different reasons. One of those people is one of our performers here, Jamie Von Stratton. She is a fashion designer based out of Everett, Washington, and she's actually had the chance to work with some amazing, amazing and talented performers and artists. Now, Jamie Van Stratton is a designer, as I mentioned, a performer, an innovator, and is a delightful person to be around. Now, one of the things that is kind of curious about Jamie is the last name. Is that actually her last name, or is that a middle name? It's actually a middle name. It was given to her by her mother, and to honor the most fabulous Diana von, and I hope I don't mispronounce this, Furstenberg. It's a German name. And it has been something that she's carried with her as she's continued to work. Her creative nature and love for fashion has meant that she's worked for thrift store finds and vintage construction. And she's had chance to work on her own label founded in 2003. She started with two shops and in Seattle, where she remained, found pieces where she found through, as I said, those thrift shops, and discovered a lot of amazing opportunities there. Since then, it's been about 15 years of her love in all things staging, fashion, vintage, and allowed her to pour her inspirations into everything that she's done. So one of the things we're going to be doing is sharing a little bit about her. This next video is talking a little bit about her pride message and a little bit about what she's been doing and what she's been up to. For some of you, you may recognize some of the names that she's worked with. And for others, hopefully you'll look them up. Again, ladies and gentlemen, and everyone in between, friends and family and folks, please help me welcome Jamie Von Stratton.
Hello, everybody. My name is Jamie Von Stratton. I'm from Seattle, Washington, and I am a proud supporter of the LGBTQ plus community. The LGBTQ plus community is art. It is friends. It is family. It is those around you. And how can one not be involved with that? How can one not support that? How can one not want to be an ally and support that community? Because it is our community. My involvement is because I am in the arts. I've been a costume designer and a burlesque performer for over 20 years. So much of what I do and my friendships are deeply rooted in that community. And many of the icons that I looked up to when I was growing up were icons of the queer community. If they weren't queer themselves, they were certainly helped along the way in terms of their styling and their wardrobe choices. Some of our favorite icons are dressed by the world's most notable LGBTQ plus people. Bob Mackie, Alexander McQueen, Jeremy Scott. I mean, the list is endless. I began my career in the arts when I was in high school. I was in musicals, and of course I wanted to be the one with the coolest costumes. So I figured out how to sew, and it has blossomed into a pretty awesome career where I have made costumes for people like Jinx Monsoon, Ben de la Creme, Macklemore. Some of you may know the show Drag Race. I have made costumes for Jinx Monsoon and Ben de la Creme. When Jinx was first on the show for season 5, she was a young queen and I had barely started doing drag costuming. So she fit into most of my costumes. So I let her borrow quite a few things, which was pretty awesome. She was taller than me. So the joke was always like Jinx was my size, but just with a torso that was like 4 inches longer. But that was amazing to see. And from there it's grown and grown and grown. And I cannot be more grateful for those queens. They are just delightful. It's amazing to see what they do. It's amazing to watch their careers flourish. Being in the world of the arts, being in the world of costume design, and being in the world of burlesque, it definitely has a ton of roots in the LGBTQ plus community. It's also incredibly awesome to see the world of burlesque become more and more inclusive. When I first started in the early 2000s, it was predominantly cis-identifying women. And now there is such an inclusivity. It's amazing. And it just allows us all to grow as performers. It allows the audience to grow and become more accepting of what sexy is. And it's amazing to see the community come together, and it's become stronger and stronger. The more that we learn, the more that we learn about each other, and the more that we embrace each other's differences. So being a part of the burlesque community is the most amazing thing, and I'm very happy that we are moving in the way of acceptance and inclusivity. I don't know what it is about the arts, and I don't know why the arts are so steeped in such a strong community of LGBTQ+, but it's fucking awesome, and that's been a joy. To wrap this video up, I'll take a personal moment and express that it is hard sometimes to see your community struggle, and it's hard to witness it and not know what you can do. The best thing that I can do is let my community know that I am here to listen, to understand, and to try to create an environment for you to feel safe, but also to be open-hearted and warm to people who may not understand, so that I can inform them that sometimes it's not the job of people who are LGBTQ+ to inform every person who doesn't who's not there yet, that sometimes it's also, as an ally, my task to try to help that along too. Because I think at the end of the day, we are all human. We all really want a chance to love and embrace one another, but sometimes our own fears can hinder us. We need someone to help us along on our journey in order to accept and love those around us. And that is how I'm hoping to contribute to my community. Not only let everyone know that I'm safe, you're safe with me, but also to let people know, people who are questioning or don't quite understand yet, know that they can talk to me and I'm not going to judge them. I'm just going to try to help them along. Thank you very much for your time. Have a wonderful day and happy Pride.
And welcome back to Pride Live. Once again, my name is Stephen DeMelio, president of Pride London Festival. And thank you once again for tuning in across North America. We really want to thank everybody who's had a chance to comment and like our statuses. It's something amazing when we see the community come together and engage. So thank you. And as Rick had said, and I was a salute to all of you. If anybody has a drink, this is probably a good time to have a bit of a sip and enjoy yourself. Once again, this is Pride Month. And we are celebrating Pride Live. As you had just seen, there was a quick advertisement for Tourism London, which is one of our main sponsors for this event. If you're in the city of London, Ontario, check out some of the amazing venues and spaces that have been advertised in that advertisement. So please check it out. We definitely want to support local. And if you're not in London and you won't be traveling to London, support local in your area. Trust me, it is certainly worth it. And I can tell you that a lot of businesses, artists are certainly hungry for it and will appreciate it. So once again, continue to support your local businesses in your area. And thank you once again to Tourism London. Now, the next performer we have is a fantastic performer and somebody I actually just recently discovered working with Pride. Nicole Tan is a born in Malaysia and initially moved to Canada to pursue her musical endeavors in classical piano and violin in 2009. Nicole has actually worked with Pride on our own Sunday Morning Joy program on the Pride London Network, and she's just an amazing talent. But Nicole has had such an amazing career just in the last couple of years as well. Upon completing her master's in vocal performance at Western University, in 2015, she found herself unexpectedly gravitating towards jazz. And, you know, she's as it says in her own bio, she didn't really think that was going to be the case. She did kind of go into real estate, so she was kind of pursuing that. You can now catch her music and local real estate agent as the most importantly lead singer of a jazz band. Nicole Tan combo. I think this seems to be a bit of a theme as we experience. Seems a lot of people are connecting. So if you're a musical artist, that's probably something you might want to think about. Nicole then had a chance to be grateful for the recipient of the 2018 Jack Richardson Music Awards, now renamed as the Four City London Music Awards. And that was as the classical vocal solo. Ever since the pandemic has hit, she has started posting regular vocal recordings on her website, on her YouTube channel, and on our own Pride London Network page. You can check them all out for free. And again, if you see PayPal information that's listed there, please support the artists. Nicole Tan can also be found on Facebook, on Instagram, and on YouTube. And you'll see her social media handles on the video when we've got it playing for you. I just want to make one more quick request. As this is Pride, please continue to support one another. I know this is a difficult time. I know this is a difficult year. We wanted to try to bring some smiles to all of your faces. So again, if you know somebody that's struggling, please think about reaching out to them just to say hello. And now, folks, please enjoy the recordings and sounds of the one and only Nicole Tan. Mm-hmm. Thank you. And welcome back. Thank you once again for joining us. This is Pride Live, an amazing celebration of Pride Month presented by Tourism London and Pepsi, and of course produced by Spectra and Budweiser Gardens. Once again, my name is Stephen DeMelio, president of Pride London Festival, and it is an honor and a privilege to be seeing all of you as much as I can, and of course speaking to all of the amazing artists and performers that are going to be presenting some of their talents to you. So far, we've had a chance to see some amazing talents from our local area and, of course, from the United States. And we're going to continue on with some amazing, great talent as well. Earlier, you heard the musings and sounds of Rick Kish Combo and Nicole Tam, both who have been on our Sunday Morning Joy. You've also heard from Jamie Von Stratton, and you're going to be hearing from some others in a few short moments. Our next artist is an accomplished musician as well, and has also performed on our Sunday Morning Joy program on Pride London Network. This individual is actually somebody who has been pretty big and up and coming over the past little while, so it's been really awesome to see. One of the things that I wanted to point out was that Cory Stewart, who is our next performer, is actually somebody who got his start based out of bullying. His story is extremely, extremely interesting to listen to. And if you ever get a chance, I would certainly suggest that you take a look into his story a little bit. But a little bit about Cory Stewart himself is he's been described as a synth pop artist with a smooth voice, as Billboard had once described him in 2020. You know, he creates fearless, unapologetic, and relentlessly catchy music. He has had beats that have been capturing minds of Canadians and Americans and people around the world for many years. He's actually been attributed by a magazine called Canada Beats in 2018. And Cory has been supporting several other legendary musicians, including George of Crystal Waters, and a number of other musicians. It's just amazing to see what he's been doing with his time over the years. Cory Stewart has debuted his album, TOV, which was released in January of 2021, so just this past year, and hitting number 9 on the iTunes pop chart, receiving overwhelming press and praise from critics. I must tell you that seeing Cory's videos and being involved with Cory in the last little while, I am blown away, and I know you will be too. So once again, to all of our venues, to all of the watchers and viewers across North America, please enjoy the next video from the one and only Cory Stewart. Salut.
I don't like is everything. So let's try it again.
Yeah.
I once heard my old man say, "You'll never get what you want." I once heard my old man say, "What's good is probably false." And I wondered to myself if the way that he sees is the reason I could be so unhappy. I once heard my mama talking, she was down on herself. I once heard my mama putting down her inner wealth. And I wondered to myself, how could this ever be? How could the woman that I treasure be so unhappy? If only I could live my life without judging me. If only I could like my own originality. If only I could see what everyone sees. Perhaps I would be less unhappy. I once was the boy you bullied, was the boy you scarred. I once was the one you called out on the cold schoolyard. How is this happening?
could live my life without judging me. If only I could like my own originality. If only I could see what everyone sees. Perhaps I would be less unhappy. I've only got one chance to make this time count. I'm running out of gas, fighting off doubt. There's no point now in going backwards. If you're unhappy, then take back what's yours. If only I could live my life without judging me. If only I could like my own originality. I am unhappy at times, I am insecure. I am unhappy at times, some days I can't find the cure. Can I remind myself again, no matter how hard it seems? Don't take this life for granted, just go after your dreams. If only I could live my life without judging me. If only we could like our own originality. If only we could see what everyone sees. Perhaps we'd all be less unhappy.
And welcome back to Pride Live. Once again, my name is Stephen DeMelio, president of Pride London Festival, and I've got my drink in my hand. Hopefully you have yours in your hand to celebrate this Pride Month. Once again, thank you to our sponsors, Tourism London and Pepsi. And of course, thank you to Spectra and Budweiser Gardens. Without them, this event would not be taking place. So we want to thank them and of course you for participating and watching. This is something that we're doing for you and for the community across North America. So once again, thank you for tuning in. And happy Pride Month. Now, we are not just done yet. We've got a few more performances for you. As I had mentioned, we wanted to try to showcase the talent across North America, not just here at home in London, Ontario, but across our great cities, across our great provinces and states. So one of the things that we decided to do is reach out and try to get as many performers from across this region as possible. And that's exactly what we've ended up doing. As you've seen some performers and some fashion designers from across this region and across North America. And in the next little bit, you'll be seeing some drag performers and drag entertainers as well. One of those drag entertainers starting us off will be Violet Seduction. Violet actually comes from us from Oshawa, Ontario. And Violet is a product of Oshawa, as I mentioned, a Canadian at the young age of 17, as part of the youth group run by the LGBTQ plus club that year, Violet was born. So just at a young age, this individual has had a chance to find their footing and become an amazing performer. Although at first she was just Violet, it wasn't long before she became Violet Seduction, everyone's favorite sexuality. And with over 8 years in the industry, she has performed in 16 cities across Ontario, seeing stages and slaying stages as she goes, serving you dance, flips, and a bit of sass along the way. This is going to be Violet Seduction on our first video. Shortly thereafter, we'll be performing another drag performer, a drag entertainer, and this time it'll be Miss J, a drag performer coming all the way out of Toronto, Ontario, Canada's largest city. Miss J is a powerhouse performer and as always leaves her audience jaws just gasping for more. You know, one of the things that Miss J has been doing is being a firecracker, leading the path to be a firecracker of energy. She's been a performer. She's been performing all across Ontario over the past 7 years, and she had her chance to debut a dazzling nightclub and dazzling places in Oshawa, Ontario, at a club called 717. Not sure if some of us may still remember that venue. And has been dazzling stages since then. And Miss J loves being the center of attention. I mean, who doesn't, right? I certainly do. And honestly, she will always dance for you. She'll always dance the house down and will set the stage on fire. She'll light the room up like no other, and, as I've mentioned, she's certainly one to watch. Once again, from Toronto, Ontario, you'll be seeing the next performance after the one and only Violet Seduction will be Miss J. And our last drag performer is from London, Ontario, right here. The one and only Phoenix Black. Now, Phoenix has actually worked with us at Pride over the years and has worked in various venues here in London. I've had a chance to meet Phoenix, and I can tell you Phoenix is one heck of a performer. You'll certainly enjoy the performance that Phoenix has for you. Phoenix is known as the dancing queen of London, Ontario, serving you twirls and twists and death drops as much as you can handle. You know, she started drag 3 years ago and has earned an opportunity to perform in for Kimchi, which is a RuPaul's Drag Race queen, if anybody is familiar with RuPaul's Drag Race, hopefully you are. Brooklyn Heights, who is, of course, Canada's own Drag Race queen, Miss Cracker, and Lemon from Drag Race Canada. And she has the opportunity to perform for more artists as she continues. Her aesthetic is described as mysterious with a dancing energy. Once again, everyone, please give a warm welcome. And as a quick reminder, all of these performers are certainly looking to have their support. So if you would like to support them, please reach out. You'll see their social media handles on the video, and you can also utilize a PayPal to donate them directly to them. Tips are always welcome for drag performers and for any performer that you're seeing. I don't have any tips available, so you can't tip me, but you can certainly provide a tip like I look good. I'll appreciate that. Anyway, once again, please enjoy the next performances. The one and only Phoenix Black, Miss J, and Violet Seduction. Salut.
Can't bite the devil on my tongue, you know. Don't need to be. machine when I do it. I'll be catching fire, gasoline when I do it. My turn. I make this look easy. Tick boom like gasoline. If they call me Lamborghini, cause I know just what I'm worth. The throw to 100, but my body make them stutter. Stop my engine, push the button, cause I'm gonna be coming first. Yeah, I'm a machine when I do it. I'll be catching fire, gasoline when I do it.
Don't
And welcome back to Pride Live. Once again, my name is Stephen D'Amelio, president of Pride London Festival. And you've just witnessed three amazing performers, Violet Seduction, Miss J, and Phoenix Black. We're not done just yet. We have two more special performances for you. So keep those wine glasses frosted and enjoy those drinks. I did want to take a quick moment, though, just to mention a few quick things. The first thing I wanted to mention is, as we are all dealing with this unique challenge around the world, wherever you are, I do want to encourage you to please continue to follow the guidelines that are set out in your area. We want to ensure that we're all getting back to being in a physical space and being with one another in the best and fastest way possible. So as a reminder for all of my Ontario friends, please continue to wear your masks. Please continue to wash your hands. Please continue to be socially distant. And please continue to respect one another when, you know, making decisions about what you do and how you're doing it. I also want to take a quick moment to mention that there, as I've mentioned, there are a lot of performers here that are hungry to come back out and perform for all of you in person. But in the meantime, you're more than able to support them in a number of different ways. You may have seen that Phoenix Black actually has their own clothing line produced by Freedom Graphics, excuse me. So, you know, if you happen to see something that you'd like, support them by either purchasing something from them, or if you happen to be in an event that they're doing, kind of like I happen to do with Bob the Drag Queen and Brooklyn Heights, you're more than able to maybe get yourself something signed by them and take it home as a commemorative piece. And lastly, I do want to quickly mention that Pride London, of course, is continuing to be heavily involved in all things Pride, not just this month and not just next month for our festival, but of course throughout the year. You're more than able to show your pride, either getting one of our fantastic hats that, of course, are produced locally here. You can, of course, grab them for about $20, or some of the other products that are, of course, available through some of the other performers. And now, I am so thrilled, so honored, and so excited to be presenting one of our last drag performers of the evening. This performer is an amazing talent, a drag king, in their own right, an amazing talent that you should not overlook. This is Johnny Comelately Ciccone. Now, Johnny has been a drag queen in London and was the winner of the ADR. Johnny is actually somebody who believes that the best time you can have is in a gay bar. And that's where Johnny's story kind of started. So again, please support Johnny. Please support all these drag artists that you're seeing. Make sure that you tip your drag performers, follow them on social media, give them a like, send them a love message. Just don't send them any hate. That's certainly not something any of us need at this time. Once again, please give a warm welcome. Send your love, send your thoughts, your chats, and your comments to us. This is the one and only Johnny Comelately Ciccone. Welcome back. Once again, my name is Stephen D'Amelio, president of Pride London Festival, and what you just witnessed was an amazing performance by the drag king, Johnny Comelately Ciccone, and I'm going to mispronounce the name, and I apologize, but this is somebody that, of course, is an amazing talent, based out of London, Ontario. As I mentioned earlier, all of the performers that you've had a chance to see, all of the acts that you've had a chance to see, are based across North America. And it's really important that you do support them as much as you can in any way that you can, whether that's just sharing their pages, liking their pages, sending them love and comments, or even purchasing material and products from them. It is something that is certainly welcome. So once again, this has been an amazing opportunity for all of us here. And for Pride London Festival, it has been such an amazing opportunity to partner with Tourism London, Pepsi, Spectra, and Budweiser Gardens to present such an amazing lineup of such great talent. I do want to take a quick moment to thank, as I mentioned, Tourism London, Pepsi, Spectra, and Budweiser Gardens for putting on such an amazing program. I'd also like to thank every one of you for tuning in and taking the opportunity for watching, for all of our performers for taking the time to put something that is enjoyable for all to watch. And of course, lastly, but not, of course, certainly not least, I'd like to thank Danielle. Danielle has been working tirelessly behind the scenes, making sure that this is all being put together. And I can't thank her enough for everything that she's been doing and everything that the team behind this event has been doing. So thank you to her and thank you to the team. Now, before we go, there's just a few quick things I wanted to mention. Pride Month is, of course, this month, and it's very important that we celebrate and that we educate and that we learn from our history. So the one thing I will challenge you to do is take some time this month and learn something new, whether that's learning something of a talent of yourself or learning something about the history of the gay rights movement. Learn something new this month. And I also challenge you to inspire others. This month and this year has been challenging for a lot, certainly has been challenging for anybody that is missing the comfort of being with one another and hugging or kissing or even touching other people. So please, please support one another, inspire one another, be positive with one another, and love one another. This year, this is so important for you to be respectful and mindful of one another's challenges, mind, peace of mind, and of course, headspaces where everybody is. So with that, there's just one last thing I want to mention. The next performance is actually myself, DJ Kevin Evans, where you can, of course, follow me on djkevinevans.com and on social media at DJ Kevin Evans. It's a little mini mix, which you, of course, can find on our Pride London Network site as well for free. For anybody that's interested, you can sign up without being a member of the organization and view all the amazing programs and fantastic events that we've had over the years. The one last thing I want to mention is that shots are not just for your dog. So wherever you are, please continue to be safe, be secure, be proud, and make sure that you're inspiring others. And as RuPaul famously says, if you don't love yourself, how can you love anybody else? Enjoy and happy Pride.
Let's do this one time for my man, DJ Kevin Evans, coming straight out of the T-Dot. That's Toronto, Canada, for all you squares out there. So somebody make some noise right now for DJ Kevin Evans. Y'all ready? Let's go!
I just wanna ball like the big leagues. I just want a nice house on the shore. I just want a big house like Caspi. So kiss me if you can. I'm chasing after my dreams. I wanna be the man. I wanna be the star on the scene.
With no broke. Now I ain't saying she a gold digger, but she ain't messing with no broke. Get down, girl, go ahead, get down. Get down, girl, go ahead, get down. Get down, girl, go ahead, get down. Get down, girl, go ahead.
She from Malibu, Malibu. If you ain't got a foreign, then she laugh at you. Malibu, Malibu. Spending daddy's money with an attitude. Roxanne, Roxanne. All she wanna do is party all night. All damn, Roxanne. Never gonna love me, but it's alright. She think I'm a asshole. She think I'm a player. She keep running back though, only cause I pay her. Roxanne, Roxanne. All she wanna do is party all night. Damn, Roxanne. Party all night.